Salutations, spooks, spirits, and specters, and welcome back to Clannad, Fuko's Route, where it's another day, and lunch is still going on, and Sunahara's passed out in the desk next to us, and Tomoya's like, you know what, instead of sleeping, I'm just gonna go ahead and take a walk around the school. So I turn around and start walking.
Oi, Okazaki! 今からじゃないぞ! 授業が終わってからだぞ!
I pretend to not hear that last bit. Now I've got plausible deniability and can blame him if I get scolded for skipping out on the rest of the day. I'm certain that Sunahara was around during lunch. Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry. That's right, Sunahara got beat the crap out of because he touched another guy's girl, a rugby team member's girl. And like, oh, ho, ho! So we're in search of Sunahara, so that way we avoid going to the teacher's room. That's right. But I'm not sure if he was around to take fifth period. I slept through the whole thing. Maybe the rugby team dragged him off somewhere. If that's the case, he's probably in some dark corner of the school now, never to be seen again. The thought makes me lose my will to find him. Tap. Tap. T-t-tap. Hmm? Someone is tapping on my back. Tap, tap. From the armpit to the waist. Tap. T-t-tap. What do you want? I turn around just in time to catch the sight of a girl running away. I recognize the figure. Must be the wood carving girl I met yesterday. Is she some kind of pervert? Tap. Again. Tap. T-t-tap. I decide to stop walking and see what happens. Tap. T-tap. T-t-tap. Not letting go of the opportunity, she keeps touching all over the place. A passing female student can't hold in her laughter as she looks at us. Tap. That is my groin. Tap. She taps there again. So you're interested in that place that much? Squeeze. Don't grab it! Surprised by my voice, she loses her balance and falls on her behind. Now she's standing up, tapping lightly on her skirt to brush off the dust. Catching her should be a piece of cake now. Gotta catch her! After all that, now she's turning her back on me, intending to run off again. Too slow! Got her arm. Got some business with me? Or have you finally awakened to gender differences at your age?
Knife.
Knife. Oh right, that! It totally slipped my mind, but I still haven't given back the knife I took from her. So she was searching for my body for it.
返してください.
How about your hand?
もう痛くないです.
But it's still got a bandage on it. Well then, shake my hand. Grip. She's trying to endure it. Next, high five. She's still trying to endure it. Very well, boxing training. You be the trainer. Just pose like this. I make her put her hands up in front of her chest. I'll punch your hands saying, jab, jab, straight! So you have to reply with, one, two, one, two. Got it?
Hi.
Are you ready?
Hi.
She closes her eyes. What kind of trainer closes their eyes? Now open your eyes and brace yourself.
I...
Her reluctant face is now equipped with round, opened eyes, making for a rather spectacular sight. Here we go.
Hi.
I'll hit with 100% power. You ready for it?
Hi.
Jab, jab, straight. I spice things up with a little bit by raising my voice.
One, two.
Bap. Very slowly, I put the knife into her hand.
One, two.
She's still going at it. Look, I gave you back the knife.
Eh?
If you hurt yourself, I'll come and take it away again. Got it? Just be careful so you won't go through this whole ordeal again.
Hi.
Bye, then. I say goodbye without looking at her face and start walking away. Wandering around at random is just getting boring. I begin to think about where he could be. Sunohara, that is. Nothing comes to mind. Honestly, I don't really care where he is at this point. I can always go back to class right before it ends. I'll just go where I feel like going. An empty classroom. The theater club's room is right in front of me, but my attention crawls to the side. I peek inside through the glass panel on the door. There she is! Unsurprisingly, a girl is sitting inside working diligently on her carving. She seems to be a lot more attentive to her work than the first time I saw her. I guess she won't get hurt now that she's used to it. Probably. I'll just watch her a bit more. I decide to keep on watching for a while. Her body, which was moving slightly, suddenly comes to a stop. And she is putting one of her fingers in her mouth. Ah, did she just? She starts looking around restlessly. And somehow, through the glass panel, she detects my watching eyes. Before her usual wah even reaches my ear, she's already jumped up and run away. Idiot, rushing like that only makes your wound worse. I quickly enter the classroom. In the corner, the girl is squatting down, facing the wall, with her head resting on her knees. Hey, show me your hand. Not a word from her. Is she trying to hide from me? Just so you know, I can totally see you. Cautiously, she turns her head around and points a finger at herself. Yes, you. Bam! She gets up and runs away again. This time toward the outside of the classroom. This idiot, stop running around with an injury like that! I start chasing after her. Where did she go? From the end of the corridor, I can see a teacher walking this way.
Okazaki-ka? そんなところで何してる?
He asks after recognizing me. Yes. One moment. Sorry, yawning. Yes, just looking for someone. A teacher asked me to.
授業中にか? 本当かどうか後で担任に聞いておくぞ。
Of course, feel free to, since it's the truth. He gives a suspicious look, then just walks past me. And something smallish is following behind him. Like I said, you are way too obvious. I grab her arm. Right after I do, she turns her head to me and puts a finger to her lips to shush me. It might not be a bad idea to listen to her now and be silent for a while. Finally, the teacher makes a turn at the corner and vanishes from our view. A sigh of relief. That went well. Now let's go to the infirmary. Just who are you trying to hide from? Listen, your hand must be hurting, right? Come with me to the infirmary.
怪我してませんから。
Stop lying. Show me your hand. The blood must be oozing out right now.
ちゃんと舐めました。
Did that stop the bleeding?
止まりました。
Really? Show me your hand.
はい。
She raises her index finger in front of my eyes. The blood seeps through the cut, making a narrow red line as a drop falls down. Quickly, she puts the finger back in her mouth and starts sucking it.
Hi.
Like a magician, she proudly shows me her finger again. The blood has indeed stopped, but... Do it again, but faster and with more spirit. Maybe yell, Yay! As you do it. Pew! The blood spouts out. Wow, very nicely executed. She's sucking her finger again. I don't imagine this will go on much longer, so I'm going to go ahead and finish out the scene. Isn't that cut pretty deep?
深かったとしても、あなたには関係ないと思います。
Like a little kid, she spills the words out with the finger still inside her mouth. Right. I guess so.
フーコがそうしたいんです。放っておいてください。
Is Fuko your name?
はい。伊吹フーコです。おかしいですか?
Not really. I just thought it may have been your name, but wasn't sure.
そうですか。それでは。
She turns the other way and starts walking away. Go to the infirmary, you hear me? I say that just to make sure. Guess I was being too meddlesome. But I can't exactly just stand and watch as she puts herself in danger like that, can I? I guess I'll go back. Just as I turn around, I remember something. There used to be a perfect place to nap in the old school building.It was the reference room. But, as this is Fuko's route, we will be not going there. And, I'll be ending the video here. And as usual, as I have done with Kotomi and Kyo's routes, I will cut straight to the next scene at the start of the next video. So until then, thank you all very much for watching. And ciao for now. Ciao for now.